Hello everyone, it's Claire. Today we are going to speak about a really interesting topic. We are going to deep dive into AppsFlyer, the state of ad creative in apps marketing 2024 edition. So why I wanted to speak about it, I was watching the webinar today and I found some really interesting insights, some insights that may even have, like double performance meaning. It's a webinar that was made with TikTok and SciPlay, organized by AppsFlyer, and I made my little analysis of their data. I'm just going to show it to you so you can see it. Nice. So you should normally see my screen. So this is the report I'm speaking about. You can find it really easily on the AppsFlyer blog, and then there is a big banner. You can see their key finding, introduction. They are speaking about AI, some quote trends, and also share of spend, IPM by gaming social, ESP social, and so on and so on. So it's a lot of interesting information, especially now that we want to have the trends, especially that I'm working with a lot of new games. So for me, it's really interesting, and especially the CPI data. I was checking especially this table, and I saw some really interesting things, especially related to the ad type and the CPI associated for each ad type, depending on the category. So I just extracted the data. I clicked on the downloads button, so I can even do it now. You are going to have a sheet, and I just made some little analysis to show basically what I was thinking about. So generally, if you have an overall look at all the AppsFlyer data, you can see that really like playable ads are killing it. If you are not doing playable ads, I highly recommend it. They have the lowest CPI. Video after is the second format that is highly recommended based on the CPI. Even if it's slightly higher than playable ads, it shows really good performance in social media. And then you have image ads, that is also an option, and especially used usually on all what is a programmatic ads network, but which actually also as well like lately a good traction on some social media as Meta, for instance. So AppsFlyer data is actually split by category, and you have hyper-casual, casual, but also core data. So I was super interesting to have a look at it because I'm working on several games from hyper-casual to mid-core. So I wanted to check basically by OS what are the recommendations. What we see is that overall, there is a correlation by format no matter the OS. But it's not always the case. Like if you take mid-core, yes, playable stays the core format that they will advise because of the CPI. But if you take hyper-casual, for instance, ad network are just killing it on Android. And maybe, you know, like you may want also to try some other format. On sport, video ads and a network really is what is highlighted on the report. And on casual, playable ads as well are really the key format. Like when I reviewed all the data, it's really what I saw was killing it. But we will go category by category just after. So on my little Rosin Consulting advice, I would say really go into the ad type optimization. We know, for instance, on Facebook, Facebook has been pushing the Facebook Reels. Do ads that are fitting, video ads that are fitting the placement. I think more than ever, it's super important to do so, but also do playable ads. Like honestly, it's really, I feel like the format that is going to make you have additional and valuable as well inventory in your stack. So don't forget to do it. Do platform specific strategy as well, because it seems like depending on your user experience, you may not want to test the same network and even format. Even if, to be honest, like playable ads seems to work on both, maybe you can see that there is some non-correlation depending on the device type. The third tips I had for you was category specific adjustment. So if you are keen to have a low CPI, yes, don't spend on mid-core. This is what the message you would have if you had look only high-level metric, upper funnel metric, and so on. But it's kind of short-minded because at the end of the day, on mid-core, we know on user acquisition, we are going to do ROI campaign. We are going to do CPE campaign. We are going to do all the qualitative campaign type that, of course, are going to increase our cost per install. So I'm not that surprised that mid-core get the highest CPI at the end of the day. And I think the most important stay your LTV, user LTV, all along, so you can keep your user in your game. So I wouldn't, be really scared to have a high CPI on mid-core, but the message that is conveyed is really that mid-core games begins to be a really expensive bet. At the opposite, hyper casual, of course, is lower, and sport, racing, and casual games are actually working quite well. So here is kind of what you can see on the report. You also have the country breakdown, which is really interesting, especially when you do like soft launch. So you can just type United States if you are soft launching in your core country. And you are just going to see the KPI per media type, category, platform, and so on. So I think this is a really insightful data, especially for all of us that benchmark. And what is really handy is that you also have several countries, I think like Saudi Arabia, which are really a country where brands, they want to expand. So where you can kind of, if you don't have the benchmark yet, build it with the benchmark. So now if we go like category by category, so I just made a little graph to show per placement, basically what kind of CPI you can expect. I think it's quite of straightforward. Once again, video and playable are really close and really performing really well. That's really one of the main, insights from the report. If you go then on the mid-core side of things, so the CPI by platform and ad type is really interesting. You see on Android and iOS, you have a CPI gap. Of course, it's cheaper on Android than iOS, but still, it's interesting to see that the gap with playable ads between Android and iOS is not that big. And indeed, here you have the breakdown per OS, and you can see playable is really like the place to go. Once again, like no matter the platform, it's really killing it. But on Android, the video CPI stay lower, especially on ad network. But after, it's normal to see a CPI lower on ad network where you are more on CTR, CPI metrics, and the quality as well, if you're not doing ROI optimization on AppLovin, is usually much lower than, for instance, the ROI campaign on Facebook if you are still able to do it because you have a good CV schema on iOS. So what is really good, and I exported it actually for my clients, is that you see all the columns. So you have a little table that you can export, and you can just reopen it and see all the data, export the columns that matter the most for you. And I think it's really what I liked the most, at least in this little part about the creative. So if I just go back and I jumped on the highlight for mid-core, so I would really say like social video ads have higher CPI compared to other type of ads. And network video ads show lower CPI on iOS. On Android platform, ad network video ads on Android have the lowest CPI and significantly lower than other ad type. So I would say if you want just cheap user acquisition, ad network, and especially with Mintegral, is definitely your place to go. Always be cautious about the phone, but having some playables there. And actually, if you take Mintegral, have a solution for this, so it may be something you want to do. So I made my little breakdown for all the categories. On hyper-casual, same video also are performing slightly less good than playable ads on iOS, and playable ads are really killing it. Like, I think across all the categories, what I did see is that playable ads is really the format where we should all invest. And I think especially with all the cloud experience nowadays, it's really something that I think is pushed by especially Facebook, but also all the other networks to have interactive experiences. So this is my little report. I'm going to add the link in the description. Of course, it will be shared on my newsletter. So if you want to subscribe, you can just click also on the link below and you can have all the insights. I really enjoyed this little report. I think what is really amazing is when you can export the data. It's really interactive. You have some simple visualization. I think what could be made even better is maybe to add the campaign type, because of course, when you speak about social media, you are going to have higher CPI because the user quality is different. The inventory type is also different. So I think it can be interesting to add those kind of information, but at the end of the day, you don't want as well to go too granular, so I understand as well that it's keeping high level, and I think it's really cute with all those little animation. For creative testing, I just want to highlight that yes, creative ad ranking is important, so your upper KPI are going to be important when you test on social media, but think about doing also a second step where you do a CPA creative testing with an event where you have a correlation with your purchase. So you can make sure as well that even if you have one ad that is really liked by the algorithm, you are going to add in your value-based optimization campaign one ad that actually can also perform in your purchase and valuable user clients that are the one actually that are.
Donc, so that are going to pay. So it was great to see you. I hope you like it. Please like or subscribe if you enjoy it. You can get the report and just download it. You have the QR code, or I add the link on my bio. So you can go in the description and just get the report. I hope you enjoy it. And see you soon in Rosin Society. Bye bye.